Praise God. Let's recite the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the glory, and the power, forever. Amen.
Oh,
humble ourselves, prepare our hearts to participate in a special tradition of the church, and that is taking part in the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, symbolically through the bread and the wine, fruit of the vine tonight. We call it Lord's Supper, a communion. Praise God. And you may be seated. Thank you. Now we obey the example that God left us. Jesus left us his example and said, as I have washed your feet, so should ye wash each other's feet. Amen. Because the servant is not greater than the master. And so if you've seen me wash your feet, then you should then wash one another's feet. This is an example that you should do. Praise God. And we did it. That's a blessing when we do this. Praise God. For those of you who came in late, Jesus taught this very thing just before the Passover. Now we'll go to Matthew chapter 26. We're going to go into our communion service here. But we want to make some remarks and say some things about participating in communion. Amen. It's a good thing you're here. It's good. It's a blessing. It's something that you should do. Amen. Matthew chapter 26, beginning at verse number 26. And it says, and as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it, for this is my blood in the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. And when they had sung a hymn, they went out into the Mount of Olives. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 beginning. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as oft as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. Okay, if we judge ourselves, we should not be judged. So it's good to examine yourselves, judge your own self, and take care of the business. If there's any need to take care of any sin or in any iniquity or any ungodly thing or uncleanness in your life, put it under the blood of Jesus. Take care of it. And that way, there's nothing to be judged. You're lighter than stone. Praise God. And that's what he's saying here. If you judge yourself and you keep yourself right, text. For God, I'm asking to bless this little message here tonight. Lord, let it be food and manna to your people. God, minister to the needs of the night, we pray. Lord, speak to the hearts of your people in that way that you have so chosen through the preaching of the word of God. I pray, God, tonight that you would do some miracles in our midst. In Jesus' name, amen. This is a good night for a miracle.
Yes.
A good night for a Holy Ghost baptism.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
This scripture's here. Are asking us to focus our minds and our thoughts on Jesus Christ's suffering and his crucifixion. Actually, the whole death, burial, and resurrection. But primarily tonight, he's talking about his apostles, his passion, his suffering that he endured to go up to the cross. Sunday morning, I mentioned a little bit about that. You'll probably hear some more about it Sunday, perhaps. Brother Alfred preached a great message last Saturday on the about Jesus going to the cross. Sometimes I don't think that we stop to focus on that, because we've been born again and we've graduated seemingly up to the Holy Ghost baptism. So we're into the worshiping and the dancing and the singing and the rejoicing, and it's hard sometimes to just set that aside and focus back on the basic thing, that which has purchased the ability to worship and to sing and to dance. Praise God. Sometimes we might say, why go backwards? It seems like we're going backwards, but the Bible tells us to do this because there is a blessing in here. And if you get too far away from the center, if you get too far away from the base, the fundamental things, you will lose the quality of what you are. The further you get, the thinner, the further you get away from the basics of the gospel, the thinner your experience becomes. It becomes tinky-tanky. It becomes powerless. It doesn't have the anointing that it should have, because we have gotten away from the basic things. Praise the Lord. I think many churches today, they don't want to hear about the blood, the suffering, the pain, the sorrows, but they just want to concentrate on the hip hip hooray Jesus. Amen. And nothing wrong with that. But here he says, as often as you do this, I want you to concentrate. I want you to focus that this, that you're going to take, when you eat this bread, you're eating the body of Christ. And I don't believe in transubstantiation, but we need to realize what that represents, and that when we take part in eating that bread, we need to realize that the pain and the suffering that Jesus bore for us to have freedom and have the liberty, amen, to come to this house tonight. And hopefully before the night's out, we will sing and dance. We will each other.
Praise the
Lord. Amen. But I'd like for us just to remember Jesus trying to go carry that cross, amen, and hallelujah, just trying to make it all the way to Calvary. It was a struggle. It was a hard thing to make it all the way to the cross. It wasn't just ran up to the cross and jumped on the cross and let's get this over with so we can go to the resurrection. No. In fact, the truth of the matter is he needed help to get to the top of the hill. He got a little down the street and man, they had to wipe his face off. They had to, people were encouraging him, and he was encouraging himself. I can hear himself speaking, saying, I gotta make it. I love them. I love them. I love them all the way to the end, it said. I love them. I love them. Hallelujah. That thing's getting heavy there. Hallelujah. Jesus, he fell out. Simon was his name. He jumped up. Somebody help the man. There he is. Break that cross all the way to Calvary. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And people were laughing. People were jeering. Look at this crazy man. They were punching him in the side. It was a heavy cross. On that cross was more than wood. In that cross were a lot of sins. It was the sins and the weight of the whole world. It's that song we sing. If he carried the weight of the world up on his shoulder, I know, my sister, that he can carry you too. Amen. If he could carry. Thank God he carried the weight all the Calvary. Yeah. That's what we want to think about. We want to think about that. He made it all the way. And there was nothing. The only thing enticing him to go up that hill was the fact that on the other side of Calvary, he said, for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. Amen. So he was coming down that road. He was coming down up the Della Via Rosa, going out of the city up to the hill called Golgotha. Amen. And he was saying, there's going to be a better day. I got to make it though. I cannot fail. Press on. Hallelujah. That's what love is. Watching Jesus carry the cross is the definition of love. For God so loved the world. God is love. We can watch God incarnated coming down the road, bearing the heavy burden of that cross, feeling the eyes and the fingers of shame and the mockery and the laughter, the humiliation of mankind to their Creator. But he did not let those things hinder him nor stop him. He managed to make it all the way to the tree. And there the Bible says, he says he laid down his life. They didn't take it from him. He laid it down. So that's what we're doing here tonight.
Yes.
And I believe that somebody here tonight can connect with what we're saying. If somebody in this house could just connect, amen, with that spirit of the cross, of the sacrifice we bring.
Hallelujah.
When you take that bread in your hand, and we pray and we bless that bread, I want you to take it and put it in your mouth.
Yes, God.
And I want you to bite down on it. When you bite down on it, think of a nail going into his body. When you bite down on that bread, I want you to think about the crown of thorns being pressed into his head. I want you to think about that whip with the metallic ends on the strings on that thing as it would slash you back and it would rip off the flesh of his head. I want you to think. Because what he did there is everything. If he would not have made it up that hill, we would not be in this place tonight rejoicing and knowing that we are saved. So praise God. he break it to give to his body which is broken? For you this do in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, this is the cup of the New Testament in my body, blood. This do ye often as ye drink it in remembrance of me. Don't even come close. They have perverted it. They're getting it so far away from what the Bible actually says on matters. It's scary. And we cannot allow the Church of Jesus Christ to come to the place that where we just kind of halfway quote the Bible, or we say the Bible says this, the Bible says that, and it's not what the Bible says. Praise God. You say, that's why we come to the church. That's why we come here teaching. That's why we come here preaching. That's why we read our Bibles and study our Bibles, is so that the Word of God can have its work inside of you. Some of you don't never come to church. And you're missing out. Because when you don't come to hear the preaching of the Word, well then, there is a purifying agent or action that's taking place when we sing the word and we pray the word and we preach the word. I saw a little example given, an illustration on this. I thought it was really cute. I'm going to close my thoughts on this one. But there was a farmer, a Scottish farmer, and he had a little boy come and working for him on the farm. And this little boy would ask, how come? Or why? Why this? Why this? And every time, the farmer said, I want to see if I can help this boy out. And so he gave the little boy a basket. He said, now I want you to go down to the river there, and I want you to fill the basket full of water and bring it back to me. And the little boy thought, that's crazy. Why does he want me to go fill the basket full of water? It's not going to hold the water. All the water will just go right out of the basket. And nonetheless, the boss said, go do it. So he went down to the river and he waded out and he filled the basket up and he raised it up. And sure enough, it just all went out. And the farmer had come by and was watching. And so he said, well, I better do this again. So he did it again and same thing happened. And so the farmer started looking at him, kind of struggling, looking, and says, well, I'm going to do this one more time, and I'm not going to do it another time because he's making a fool out of me. not going to be his food. He said, but he picked it up and put it full into the water and raised it up again, and all the water went out. And the lad, he said, he just took the basket and threw it up on the shore. And he said, that was what he said. You're not going to laugh at me anymore. I'm not going to be your fool. Amen. The man didn't say anything. And he reached out, picked up the basket. He held it up to the sun, and he looked. He said, oh, yes, this basket is much cleaner now. Hallelujah, than it was. Praise the Lord. Sometimes you wonder why. I'll tell you what. God is doing a work in us. God is working in you. Hallelujah. And you're getting purged. You're getting cleansed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So that's what we're doing here tonight. Hey. Thank you, Brother Paul. This is bread. Symbolizes the body of Christ. Praise the Lord. We're going to break off pieces for you. Small piece for a small big piece for a bigger. I just wonder how much pain. I've never really had to suffer in my life. I've never been suffered like, in my body. Because I've been abused, or I've been beat up, or anything. Or put in prison. Some of y'all have been in jail an hour or two. Hallelujah. I've never been put in jail. I've really been on kind of a charred life, I guess. So I can't identify maybe like some of you that identify with suffering that Jesus had to do. Praise God. So ushers will come now and help me. We'll give out the bread. Don't eat it. Get your piece over. We'll do it all together. Precious God, only you far away stood an old bloody cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross,
yes, God,
for the dearest and best, for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies and at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. He took the bread, he broke it, and he blessed it. Our Father, art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity, hallelujah, to participate in this communion tonight. Lord, I pray that your will would be accomplished in this house. God, that each of us, Lord, will be brought back to remember. Roll back the curtains of our memories. God, roll back the curtain of our memories to those first days.
is the blood of Jesus. Is the blood. Is the blood of Jesus. Oh, just worship the blood. Worship the blood of Jesus. Oh, just worship the blood. Worship the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus.